really started working on this project, I guess, last semester in our molecular biology course, and now she's taken that and extended that into a project for independent research. So she's currently doing that now. So she's here to share a little bit about where her work is currently at, and where it's going. So I'll turn it over.
Good morning. As for Torres, my name is Marlon Alvarez. I'm a junior biology major. And I don't know if I actually know how to change the slide.
The little pointer you have it. Oh, here it is by the left.
Oh, okay. Sorry. Thank you. This project analyzes the identification transcriptome of the Timberalis snake, focusing on the return protein. So the Timberalis snake is found in the eastern United States in deciduous forests and rugged terrain. The adult snakes grow between 91 and 152 centimeters, which is roughly 3 to 5 feet, and between 500 and 1500 grams, which is 1 to 3 pounds. The max reported length is 189.2 centimeters, or roughly 6 feet long. They are a member of the pit viper family, or Viperidae, meaning that they have heat-sensing organs to help them detect and capture prey. They are complex and protein-filled venom they rely on for feeding and defense and to begin digestion. Proteomics, which is the study of the entire complement of proteins that can be expressed over venom, can be used to study patterns of composition, but analyzing the transcriptome, which is the total messenger RNA molecules expressed, can be more helpful. Proteomics fails to differentiate members of large venom gene families and to provide information on sequence divergence. Snake venoms are actually quite simple in terms of the number of gene families present. There may be fewer than 20 gene families and likely hundreds of individual members of the families. So for many snake venoms, the death of the prey is due to respiratory or cardiovascular failure. Cardiotoxins, neurotoxins, coagulation factors, and some other substances are typically found in snake venoms. Venoms contain pharmacologically active substances that affect vital processes, such as action of the heart, function of nerves and muscles, blood circulation, and cell membrane permeability. Because of these highly specific modes of action, it is of great value to identify the different components of the venom. Aside from developing treatments for snake bites, the properties of snake venom have been shown to be medically useful. The black mamba, which is native to Africa, has been found that it has analgesic properties in its venom called mambalgins, which has been found to be as effective as morphine without the side effects. And copperhead, which is native to North America, has also been found to have contortostatin, which is helpful in preventing clotting and has also been found to be useful in preventing metastasis. So in our research, we attempted to construct a cDNA library for full-length transcripts from Timberalis snake venom phloem tissue. We screened the venom phloem library for potential venom proteins, and we have conducted sequencing analysis on our gene panels. So three Timberalis snakes were collected from South County, Alabama, and venom was collected 72 hours prior to tissue extraction to ensure maximum expression. Then the venom phloems were collected from all specimens. mRNA was isolated from glands using phenol chloroform extraction method, and complementary DNA was synthesized from mRNA samples using reverse transcriptase enzyme. cDNA was inserted into a bacteriophage vector for cDNA library construction. Recombinant bacteriophages, which are viruses that infect bacteria, were used to infect the host cells, which in this case were E. coli. The infected E. coli cells, which are called plaques, were randomly selected from the surface of the autoclave. The clones were then submitted for DNA sequencing. So the plaques in this bottom picture are the areas where the bacteria are not growing because they have been infected by viruses with the rattlesnake DNA components. So today, over 400 plaques have been screened via PCR to determine if the vector accepted the rattlesnake DNA, and over 200 of the screened clones have been selected and sequenced. The clones of interest containing sequences for potential venom components have been isolated, cataloged, and frozen for future analysis. One particular clone, VG100, was found to contain a homolog for a vascular endothelial growth factor-like protein, and it was selected for further analysis. So this is some examples of the proteins that are being explored, and PERTRAN is a protein that we are interested in at the moment. The initial sequence comparison indicated that the clone was 84% similar to the previously reported PERTRAN sequence. The initial sequence was less than 500 base pairs and did not contain full open reading frame, and it was a segment of the 3' untranslated region. Further sequencing of the homolog produced a complete open reading frame sequence. The total length was 1,066 base pairs, and the open reading frame was 435 base pairs, making the protein 144 amino acids in length, which is a relatively small protein. The sequence was 98% similar to previously reported PERTRAN sequence. So this research represents the first reported PERTRAN homolog from the timber rattlesnake transcriptome. There really isn't much research available on PERTRAN yet. Yamazaki et al. Discovered the protein in 2008 from the western diamondback rattlesnake venom. And there's really just the one paper on it so far. It is a vascular endothelial growth factor-like protein, or VEGF. And they're going to be instrumental in angiogenesis, which is the development of new blood vessels from existing ones. And overexpression of VEGFs has been shown to promote tumor expansion and metastasis. In the venom, it acts by increasing toxicity, by increasing membrane permeability. And future research will focus on determining function of protein and attempt recombinant expression of the protein. Because it is a simple protein with predictive folding patterns, it could allow for expression of the protein from bacteria.